but nonetheless man-made remotely powered vehicle? Or is it a genuine UFO? Take a look at this sequence. At first sight, the object appears to be nothing more than debris caught up in a gust of wind. But watch, is this really debris, or is it something else? Now compare it to this object, which Anthony Woods captured on film on a relatively mild, calm day. Are the two one and the same? And what are we to make of its extraordinary shape and aerobatics? When Tim Farrell came to examine this particular sequence, it certainly intrigued him. Now retired from the RAF and living in Cornwall, Tim is an expert witness often called upon to give evidence on video footage. He could not explain the object and wondered, what's keeping it up? But by far and away the most unusual looking UFO ever filmed by Anthony Woods is this. Filmed in the presence of his brother-in-law, Tony, this extraordinary object is like nothing ever seen, nor photographed or filmed, in UFO history. Here now is the sequence in full for you to ponder. We wanted to know what was going through the minds of both Anthony and his brother-in-law Tony as they observed this extraordinary object.
This sighting on the 27th of the 3rd of this year was absolutely amazing. Both me and my brother-in-law witnessed it, and it was something that we have never ever seen before. It appeared to have structured lights on it. Just amazing sighting, wasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, because the first thing that struck me about it was the light sequence. Now, they were changing, going on and off, and the object was moving very gracefully across the sky. I mean, we were just looking up, and it caught our attention out of the corner of our eye, and it was just there. And the lights themselves are really bright. I mean, I've got a good view in the binoculars, and they're very intense light.
You said they're dome-shaped, didn't you?
Yeah, the lights had a sort of a curved shape to them. They were definitely coming out of the surface, and the colour was so intense. And the object was quite large. Yeah. And it showed that, especially against the blue sky.
And it was interesting that as the object was slowly moving, hovering on occasions, it kept flashing these lights at us. It was almost like it was doing it on purpose, but it was very, very odd. I think it's good that with the trees in reference, you can sort of get a taste of the movement of the object.
Yeah. It wasn't particularly very high to begin with. At the beginning, it was quite sort of low. As it went on, it sort of increased in altitude, but it was in no hurry.
Most unusual object I've ever seen.
Yeah. Spectacular. Mm.
To help in our understanding of the makeup of this object, we commissioned Andrew Fry to undertake a painstaking frame-by-frame analysis of the footage. Andrew, whose background in computer animation has seen him work on hit movies such as Jurassic Park, used some of the most sophisticated computer software available to come up with this amazing 3D rendition. Here, he explains how he went about that process and offers his thoughts as to what the object might be, and definitely is not.
I received the video from you, and I'd already previously, and was really, really intrigued. Now, I thought it was an outstanding piece of filming, and I thought I could clean this up and it would be good to see what it looked like. So the first thing I did was enlarge the image, which would produce that ship there.
There it is.
gone up towards it. Gone past it.
Wait,
See the way it's moving?
Collection of objects in the sky, filmed not only by Anthony but by his wife as well. Two separate cameras.
Not pointing it in the sun, am I?
No.
The speed of it. I'll be moving.